Hi everyone, how are you all? Welcome back once again, myself Shomiran sir, and today I am again back with you with your environmental science class. So I hope you have already given successfully the post midterm examination, and here we will start the chapter of your annual examination. So you can see class 4 environmental science chapter number 23 Pochampalli explanation part 1. So let us proceed the chapter. You can see chapter number 23 Pochampalli. So at the end of this lesson, what we will learn? Okay, know about the traditional art like Pochampalli, know about the process of making Pochampalli sarees, identify different kinds of tools to be used for to make a saree. So these are the three things, important things, after completing the chapter we will come to know about. Okay, so watch the video till the end, and at the end of the video some questions are there, you will try to solve the question by your own, then I will help you if you cannot. So let's see. So let us start the chapter. Vani and Prasad live in a village called Muktapur. So where do they live? They live in a village called Muktapur. Their home is always filled with bundles of bright colored thread. So their home is always filled with bundles of bright colored thread. I hope you know what are the thread. Okay. Their mother and father and everyone else in the family are weavers. The weaving that they do is very beautiful and special. So why their house or home is always filled up with bundles of thread? Because their parents are weavers. Weavers means those who weave the clothes. From the thread they used to make the cloth. Okay, and those cloth the tailor used to cut it into different shapes, and they are making our dresses, shirt, pants, frock, what we are using. So whatever the clothes and the sarees we are wearing, first from the thread the weaver used to weave it. Okay, so Muktapur village is in Pochampalli town or a mandal in Telangana. So mandal means the small town. So Pochampalli is a town in Telangana. You know that where is Telangana is located in India? Telangana is a state of South India. Okay, previously the interstate is known as Andhra Pradesh. Later it has been divided from and a new state is formed known as Telangana. So at present Pochampalli is a town located in Telangana. Most of the families in these towns are weavers. So what is the main occupation of most of the people? The most of the people in this town, they are weavers. They used to weave the clothes from the threads. That is why the special cloth that they weave is called Pochampalli. So Pochampalli actually is the special type of cloth that they used to weave. So it is a town. In the town maximum people are weavers, and they used to weave the clothes, and these types of special clothes are known as Pochampalli. So have you understood? The villagers have been doing their work for a long time. Vani and Prasad's parents learned weaving from their elders. So the villagers, those who are living in this small town of Pochampalli or a mandal, small mandal, from a long time they are engaged in the works of weaving. And the weaving process, okay, they have not learned in any school. Whatever the weaving, they have learned from their elders. And the elders are always helping the juniors to learn the process of weaving. So up to this much I have explained. Now few of the pictures I will show you, which will make your clear concept. Then we will proceed on the next part of the chapter. See, here are some colors. They are called the dye. Okay, dyeing means the coloring. Okay, so the white threads, either they are obtained from the cotton or from the silk, they are dyed or colored. Okay, and they are converted into colorful bundles of thread. And this thread the weaver used to weave it. So just now we have already discussed about the Pochampalli town. So where it is located, you can see here is Telangana. It is a Telangana state, and over there a small mandal is there which is known as Pochampalli. It is a small town. Okay. So here are some pictures of the Pochampalli sari. It is a special types of sari. There's the villagers of that small. It is a small town, not considered. So of Pochampalli. So they used to weave these types of clothes or sari. You can see the picture on the screen. So let us proceed to the next part of the chapter. So from the previous slide, I hope you have already understood about where Pochampalli is located, okay, and what types of clothes they used to weave. Now, Vani and Prasad also helped their parents after coming back from the school. This weaving requires hard work, and many different things have to be done before actually weaving. So weaving is a very hard work. Okay, before weaving, several types of different types of things and procedure used to be done. Okay, and Vani and Prasad, after returning from the school or coming back from the school, they are also helping their parents by weaving these clothes. So from the thread to cloth. Now we will learn about the process. The process from which the thread is converted into cloth. How it is converted. Okay. Father bring bundles of thread from Pochampalli town. Mother then puts this thread on boiling water to wash away the dirt and the stain. So his father, their father used to bring the bundles of thread from Pochampalli town, and their mother puts this thread into the boiling water to wash away the dirt and the stain. So the whatever the threads are coming from the market, it contains several types of dirty things or the stain. So they are boiled into the hot water. Everybody works to dye the thread with the bright colors. Then the thread is dyed. D-Y-E, dye. Here dye means to color. Okay. So everybody used to dye the thread into bright colors. So colors are used. It is mixed with the water, and then the threads are put into the buckets or the tubs or whatever it is, and it is colored or dyed. These threads are then dyed and rolled into bundles. These bundles are put into looms and the cloth is woven. Okay, so then the threads are dried after taking out the thread from the bucket or color of bucket. Okay, it is put into the bucket or in the tubs, big tubs, which is filled up of the color, and then the white threads are converted into colorful, bright colorful threads. Then they are taken out from there. And the wet, that when the thread is colored, it is wet because it is mixed or put dipped into the colored. So these threads are then dried, okay, and rolled into bundles. After drying, what the process is there, it and rolled into bundles. These bundles are put into looms and the cloth is woven. Then loom, okay, loom is the machine, okay, hand looms, or maybe it is a power loom from where the weaver used to weave the cloth. So the cloth is woven. Okay, the weaver used to woven the clothes. Silk clothes and silk saris are woven from the silk thread, and cotton threads are used to weave cotton saris, cotton cloth, sheet, etc. So there are two types of thread. From where the threads are obtained? From the silk. Okay, silk thread mainly obtained from the silkworm. Okay, and they are used to make the silk sari. Okay, these silk threads are woven and they are mixed into silk sari. And the cotton threads are used to weave the cotton saris. Okay, and another type of thread are there which is obtained from the cotton. So the cotton thread is used to weave the cotton sari, clothes, sheet, etc. The loom has many needles. The size and the number of the needles change according to design. So in the piece of cloth or on the sari you can find several types of design. So how these designs are made? These designs are made by the needles. The looms are having, the machine of the looms are having several needles, and according to the size of the designs, the number of needles are increased or decreased. The weaver weaves beautiful pochampalli sarees into bright colors. So from the colorful threads, the weaver used to weave the pochampalli sarees into bright color. Though their traditional craft had been made, their region world famous, and it is a traditional art. It is an old form of art of making the sari, and this traditional art make their region, okay, the Pochampalli region in Telangana, world famous. So it is up to the first part of the explanation. Now I will show you some of the pictures in the slide which will make you clear concept about the loom, about the weaving, about the dyeing, etc. So you see, here is a picture of silkworm. I have given one picture of silkworm, and from the silkworm we are getting the silk thread, and it is converted into silk sarees. Okay, from the silk thread we are getting silk sarees. Okay, the silk thread are used to weave silk sarees. And another part of thread, another type of thread is obtained from the cotton. So here is a cotton plant, one picture. From the cotton balls are collected, and they are from there the small fibers or the threads of the cotton, okay, and from that cotton thread, okay, cotton thread, we are making the cotton sari or cotton sheet or the cotton clothes, etc. So just now I have explained you about the two types of threads. Okay, one is the silk thread which is used to make the silk clothes or silk saris. Another is the cotton thread which is used to make the cotton clothes or the saris. Here you can see one man is dyeing the thread. So here is a big tub which is filled with red color, and the man is dipping the thread inside it and then putting it out from, and then this thread, it is dried in the sun and then rolled into bundles, and ultimately this colored thread is woven by the weavers and converted into the clothes. Here is another picture. You can see one man is dyeing the clothes, and it has been converted into several color. So this process, okay, dipping the thread into the big tubs, okay, which is filled up with colors, and this way the threads are dyed. Here are some pictures of the colorful thread you can see on the screen, and then ultimately it is dried. Okay, these threads are dried and they are put into bundles. Here is also one picture you can see, one man is dipping the thread inside the big bucket which is colored and coloring the thread. This coloring is called the dyeing of thread. Now in this picture you can see the looms. Okay, these are the machines for weaving the clothes. There are two looms, the pictures are given over here. This is called the looms. Through here, by this help of this loom, the weaver used to weave the clothes. They are called the looms. Okay, it is a hand loom, or maybe it is a power loom, which is operated by manually or the human being directly. They are called the hand looms, and power looms, it is operated by the machinery automatically. Okay, now here I will show you one video, okay, about the Pochampalli sari. So watch this video. Okay, a part of the slide of the video is shown, and after this I will give you some question to solve.
Finishes her homework offices a photo album kept on the table.
Bubu, look at this photo album. Let's see the pictures.
Zia and Bubu start looking at the photos in the album. Saris are of various types. Do you know the names of some of the saris? At the same time, Zia's mother comes to her room.
Zia, what are you doing?
I am looking at some old photos in this album, Mummy.
Oh, wow. Let me also take a look.
Zia's mother also starts going through the album.
Mummy, your sari looks very nice. But I have never seen this sari before.
This is a very different kind of sari. It is called Pochampalli sari and it is very famous in India.
Pochampalli sari. What kind of sari is this, Mummy?
Have you ever heard of Pochampalli sari?
Pochampalli artisans of India.
What's this Pochampalli, Mummy?
Pochampalli is the name of a town. It is located in the state of Telangana.
Do you know where Telangana is? See this map of India and tell.
That's why you will find bundles of colorful threads at everyone's homes there.
Huh? They must be very beautiful.
Yes, indeed, Zia. And as all this weaving work is done in Pochampalli, the sari is known by the name Pochampalli.
Mummy, from where did the artisans learn this weaving?
The weaving of Pochampalli saris has been going on for generations. Most artisans have learned this work from the elders in their homes.
This is a good thing. But how do they weave saris?
Do you know how saris are woven? Have you ever seen saris being weaved?
From the market and put them in boiling water.
Mummy, why do they use boiling water?
Boiling water removes all the stains and dirt from the threads. Then they dye these threads in different colors. Then these threads are dried and rolled into bundles. Bundles are put onto looms. Then saris are woven from it.
But Mummy, how do they make designs on saris?
Have you ever thought how are designs made on saris? Think about it for a while.
There are many needles in the loom. Is increased or decreased according to the requirement of the design.
Oh wow! I had no idea that such beautiful designs are made with needles.
And Zia, various things are made from different types of thread.
There are different types of threads? I never knew that.
Zia did not know. But did you know about the different kinds of threads? Can you name some types of threads?
Yes, like silk thread and cotton thread. episodes are woven with silk thread. And cotton sarees, bed sheets and clothes fabrics are woven with yarn of cotton.
Mummy, it would be so nice to see threads turning into sarees.
Now students, you can see on the screen there are a few questions. I hope you have enjoyed the small video of cartoon about the Panchampolli sarees as well as what I have discussed. After that, these are some questions that you have to be prepared by yourself, and that I will discuss on the class. So question number one, where Panchampolli is located? So Panchampolli, where it is located? I hope you know, you will find it out from the video and your book. I will write it down in your copy. Vani and Prashad home is always filled with bundles of dash. So what things, what are the things which are filled up always in the house of Vani and Prashad? Third question, why looms need many needles? So what are the requirements of the needles for the looms? Next question, number four, do you know how are thread dyed? So what are the procedure of the dyeing of the thread? Okay, I have already shown you in the video and the slide about the process of dyeing. I hope you can write it down. And the fifth one is, who are called the weavers? So after watching the entire video as well as after going through the book, I know that you can also write this answer, who are called the weavers. So thank you student, today up to this much. Again, the next part of the chapter we will explain in the part 2. Thank you everyone.